Eclipse is coming in with the upper bracket advantage. It's time, though, ladies and gentlemen. Let's get into it. Over here on the blue side, it is going to be our European team, and our orange team is going to be represented by North America. It's Eclipse on the orange side, and it is going to be Jax on the blue side.
That's right. Here comes the final showdown. Aventer is actually playing defensively as they approach the goal. They're not getting too crazy as they get started. See if they can pick apart how much energy they have left.
Aventer is sitting in the goal. He's going to have to go up against both Palador and iShiny. Oh, and another player up on top of him, too. Not going to be able to stop it, though. Immediately, Lemming slams in a goal, and it's Eclipse already ahead, just 30 seconds into the first round.
And you can see from Aventer's point of view, he never looked up. He didn't see that Lemming was just hiding on the ceiling, waiting for a chance to attack. It's why he goes up there. It's very hard to remember that somebody might just be chilling out on the ceiling, waiting for an opportunity to shine.
Into the second round, of course. Now that the opening joust has already gone by, possession will go over to Jax. They're going to have an easier time picking this back up. And the launch gate, we will more than likely see Aventer holding back as the QB to be able to send a pass over towards Boop or Slit. There we go. Aventer picks it up. Ooh, just barely gets that away, too. Look at how quickly Lemming bounced off of Aventer, yep, though, to be able to go into the side tunnel. Some beautiful stuff there to keep the momentum going. And immediately, though, Aventer still moving up with Boop. He's playing aggressive now, so it looks like he's willing to take that risk again.
Oh!
Almost bounces it off the middle diamond to be able to score right there. Very, very close indeed.
But it's a very hard shot to make and a very hard shot to block, and he did it.
However, Jax still staying in the game right now, still keeping their capability to fight alive here. Oh, another diamond shot almost connecting there too, but Boop's going to be able to maintain possession. Lemming sticking back up on him though, so he's going to have to be very careful about that. Aventer sending another pass over to Boop, but Boop doesn't have a clear shot towards one of his teammates or the goal for that matter. Hugging the ground right now to hide his hitbox a little bit here, but iShiny's coming in to try and stop him. Still completed the pass over to Aventer, off the backboard, but again, another miss. Jax is being presented with so many opportunities to score, but right now they can't do it. Possession's been changed though. Lemming's picking it up, and he's heading to the other side.
Lemming cannot make these long shots, so he just ditches the disc rather than just hear that ding and let him bring him down. He's given up on trying to do that part of the game, but he can do every other part quite well.
We've got it. Palador getting it back under his control. Aventer, in the meantime, has already transferred himself to back over towards Jax's goal, so they've got a good defense matrix set up over there. Now, in the meantime, though, possession changed again. We can see one of the orange players there from Eclipse slapping it down to the ground to make it as difficult as possible for Jax to maintain that possession. And Lemming successfully picks it back up, gets the pass towards iShiny, and is going to keep going back and forth with his teammate, although a missed pass sends it into the open very, very close to the two-point bubble here on the orange side. There's going to be trouble for Eclipse if they can't maintain that. Looks like they're controlling it still, though, having to pass it between their teammates. They still got it in their bubble. They definitely want to get it out of here, especially with Slynn going around and punching everybody out.
I'm not entirely sure what they're doing. They're trying to lure them out of position to get an opportunity to rush the goal, waiting for a cherry picker to sneak down the edge. There's a lot of different moves they could do here, but I feel like they just, like, you know, we just got to defend and run down the clock. 2 points is enough to win with? Is that what they're going, or just waiting for them to rush the goal?
If anything right now,
there it is. That's what they're looking for.
If anything right now, Eclipse, as you were mentioning there, was doing a great job of wasting a whole lot of time because we're down past the halfway point of the match here now, and Jax has not been allowed to do anything significant in terms of getting close to a goal here. Like I said, though, they've been presented with opportunities that just haven't been able to capitalize on it just yet, because Eclipse has been doing a great job of running interference, and now they move in. As you said, punch out the goalie. Aventer is taken out of the fight, and that's a free goal for them then.
Yes, yes, that is their move. A lot of players love to do that move, punch out the goalie and do it, but no team does it more consistently than Eclipse. They don't even like to approach the goal if the goalie hasn't been knocked out. However, the EU goalies are fairly good at blocking with their head when they've been knocked out. We just didn't see that this time around. Of course, if you block their view of the disc with your body when the disc is coming through, they might not be able to hit it.
Launch coming out from Jax. They're going to launch into the arena here. And again, it's Aventer that's going to be the QB, tossing the pass in. Another quick bounce coming out from Lemming as well. They're trying to keep up with the disc very quickly. iShiny steals it away, sends it back over to the mid to Palador. Palador still trying to maintain control, but he has to send it a little bit further back. Slynn trying his best to keep up with this disc, but he just can't right now. So for the time being, Eclipse is going to maintain control. It will turn into a bit of a scrap, you can see here on the other side of the arena. Right now, Palador and iShiny just continuously tossing it back and forth between the two of them in order to keep possession under the control of the orange team. Eclipse, this is, and also waste as much time as possible.
Oh, for sure. And if it's something you watch at that initial joust, whenever they come up there, Lemming, he rushes the quarterback in order to force him to make a decision, then immediately jumps off his head so that he has what he needs.
And they're moving in again, right back off of the backboard. Sadly, Jax is continuing to play this aggressive strategy. So once again, we see the blue team's goal. Jax's goal is left wide open for the taking. And that's going to be an easy two-pointer for Eclipse to go up to now 6-0. Blue team, Jax, they've only got a minute and a half to bring this back.
And you're going to see that counter strategy. Here's something to actually pay attention to when you see this Joust. This is how they counter them having Joust possession. Lemming forces the quarterback to push it. Then he bounces off your head so that he has all the momentum he needs. What the quarterback needs to do is actually slam on the brakes right before he throws the disc so Lemming does not get any momentum.
Certainly going to help to slow him down a little bit to keep him from throwing things away. We just see him moving in. The pass goes off
there
way before this time. Lemming gets the hit.
He slammed on the brakes and isn't giving it
yep.
up.
And there we go. Perfect timing as well because it left the goal open, left them vulnerable, and allowed for Jax to sneak in and get a three-pointer.
That was the move, and he did it. Slammed on his brakes. Lemming held onto his feet, and he's like, no, I am going nowhere. You are getting no momentum from me. One of my favorite things to say to him during the beta days. Lemming will grab onto me, and he's like, I know you're there. I'm going to stay right here. You're walking.
Down to a minute and a half, a little bit less than that actually here. And with Jax scoring a three-pointer, if they can do that again, they can immediately tie this game back up. It's going to be coming down to the wire here indeed. But the problem for Jax is that they now lost possession. Eclipse is going to start with it this time. Let's see how they're getting aggressive. It's the launch. They're sending themselves across the arena. They didn't get nearly enough speed. They only made it to about the halfway point. Palador maintains control. But here's the thing. Eclipse is going to continue to play passively. They need to try and get at least get it to the other side of the arena here so that if Jax does change the possession up and steals the disc to take it for themselves, they're not going to have to worry about a quick goal going against them.
They don't have to be aggressive. They just have to keep it tight and make sure they have more points on the board. That's all they got to do is just wait it out.
Just keep it on Jax's side of the arena, basically. But Jax is going to do a good job bouncing it back. Way to either side. It will go off the bumper.
Looks like Eclipse is using the other players to get that momentum rather than using each other.
Yeah, there we go. Eclipse first to beat them over here towards the disc. They're going to be able to pick this back up. Bit of a fight between one of the more forward players for Jax as well, but the time is getting low. Like we said before, Jax needs to move in, get another three-pointer off. They want to try and take this into a sudden death overtime.
And it looks like it's going to be a passing game unless they have a free shot.
Well, this is not going to be good if they can score again. That'll
no.
steal it, and there we go. Palador slamming it into the goal. 8-3 becomes the scoreline, and that may as well secure the first round for Eclipse, unless we can see a miracle coming out from Jax.
Oh man, that is the first round, and inauspicious indeed. It does not look good for Jax in this first round. Now, we've often been told this by EU players that Jax usually do not perform well in their first round. So, yeah, it might be to be expected, but Eclipse are no scrubs, and this is an example of how tight their play is, and they're playing very conservatively.
Jax going to be launching back out again. They have possession, but we've already seen how quickly Lemming is able to move. They stick as a three-man team this time. And look, Lemming's just going to ride on top of them. They go back to the other side. Possession is immediately changed over to Eclipse. Only 15 seconds left now. Although we do see another two-pointer being brought in there from Jax.
So fast, so quick, you couldn't even see it.
Very quickly snuck back in there. Impressive stuff from Jax to keep the pressure on. Problem is, though, again,
they don't have possession, so Eclipse are just going to run the clock down at this point.
And I don't think it's realistic that Jax would be able to take one, get the possession back, and score within 16 seconds. This would be amazing if Jax could pull it off. But let's see.
It was an own goal, I'm pretty sure, actually.
I think it might have been two.
Not entirely sure why you did that.
Because we didn't see, I don't think we saw a name.
Oh, I get it. He's like, we can afford to give you this two-pointer because now we'll just run down the clock because we have possession. Never thought about doing that before.
That's a mind game strat right there, actually.
Yeah.
That's impressive stuff. But at the end of it, Eclipse does take control over round number one. Remember, they've come in from the upper bracket, so they only need to win a singular best of three to be the season one champions. They're one round away from the title.
Very clever tactic to actually own goal it so that you can retain possession so you can burn the clock knowing that you're not going to give up too many points.
Definitely.
What a move. Oh, man,
interesting way to play, to say the least, yeah. Take a risk like that, but it works out well. Change the possession up and keep them away from the goal.
All right, we'll see if Jax can actually turn it around. This is what they like to do. First round is usually just them working it out. Second round is usually when they're able to turn it around. We may not